Your journey into the heart and soul of Greece. And now, member-supported Hellenic Public Radio Cosmos FM 91.5, a bilingual Greek-American radio program coming to you every day through WNYE 91.5 FM from the Demetrius and Georgia Kaloidis Broadcasting Studios to the greater New York area and worldwide through cosmosfm.org. Our programs air Monday through Friday from 7 to 8 p.m., Saturdays from noon to 3:30 p.m., and Sunday mornings from 9 to 1:30 p.m.
Γη της λεμονιάς της ελιάς, γη της αγκαλιάς της χαράς, γη του πέφτου του κυπαρισιού, των παλικαριών και της αγάπης, χρυσοπράσινο φύλλο ρηγμένο στο πέλαγο. Γη του ξεραμένου λιβαδιού, της πικραμένης Παναγιάς, γη του Λίβα τα δικού χαμού, τα γριού καιρού των ηφαιστείων, χρυσοπράσινο φύλλο ρηγμένο στο πέλαγο. Γη των κοριτσιών που γελούν, γη των αγοριών που μεθούν, Κύπρος της αγάπης και του όνειρου, χρυσοπράσινο φύλλο ρηγμένο στο πέλαγο.
Good evening. Welcome to Cosmos FM. This is Despina Afentouli. This program is dedicated to the memory of a businessman and philanthropist, Nikos Mouyiaris.
Cosmos FM.
Support for Cosmos FM is made possible by the support of our members and contributions from... At Investors Bank, one of our goals is helping businesses grow. Whether your company needs an equipment loan, line of credit, or real estate financing, Investors Bank can help. Because our lending decisions are made locally, our bankers can respond quickly with financing solutions to meet your company's needs. 855-IBANK4U or online at myinvestorsbank.com. Investors Bank, banking in your best interest. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. NMLS ID number 41179. The Heian Federation announces that they are hosting a blood drive for the American Red Cross on Wednesday, January 23rd from 2 to 7 p.m. at their Cultural Center, 4401 Broadway in Astoria. To make an appointment, visit www.redcrossblood.org using the sponsor code HEANFED. The Pan-Macedonian Studies Center and the Pan-Macedonian Association of the Greater New York District invite you to their 2019 Vasilopita celebration on Sunday, January 13th at 1 p.m. at the Pan-Macedonian Studies Center in Whitestone. For more information, call 718-747-0488.
Ενημέρωση. Πολιτισμός. Ψυχαγωγία. Κόσμος FM.
Welcome back. You're listening to Cosmos FM through WNYE 91.5 FM. This is Despina Afentouli for Cosmos FM. And tonight, this program is dedicated to the memory of the businessman and philanthropist, Nikos Mouyiaris. Nikos Mouyiaris passed away on January 5, 2019, an obituary announcement said. He was born in Athenou village in Cyprus in 1945 and settled to the United States in 1964. He held graduate and postgraduate degrees in chemistry from St. John's University and Rutgers University accordingly. In 1975, he founded a cosmetics company, Mana Products, in New York. His company was grown over the years and created formulas for international cosmetics companies and makeup artists. Today, Mana has more than 800 employees. Apart from his professional achievements, Nikos Mouyiaris supported Hellenism and national issues of Greece, Cyprus, and the United States. He founded HALC, the Hellenic American Leadership Council, and was on the board of organizations including the Hellenic Initiative, Coordinated Effort of Hellenes, and the Pan-Cyprian Association of America. He was a philanthropic supporter of the elitist chair at Rutgers, Children's SOS Villages in Greece, Malaika Foundation in Congo, Paradise for Kids in Sierra Leone, and other organizations. Nikos Mouyiaris was honored for his contribution to business and the national issues of Greece, Cyprus, and the United States.
Ανηφοριά θα πάρω μονοπάτια να βρω τα σκαλοπάτια που πάν στη Λευτεριά. Θα αφήσω αδέλφια συγγενείς τη μάνα τον πατέρα μες στα λαγκάδια πέρα και στις φουνοπλάγες μες στα λαγκάδια πέρα και στις φουνοπλάγες. Ψάχνοντας για την λευτεριά θα έχω παρέα μόνη κατά λευκό το χιόνι βουνά και ρεματιές. Τώρα κι αν είναι χειμωνιά θα έρθει το καλοκαίρι τη λευτεριά να φέρει σε πόλεις και χωριά, τη λευτεριά να φέρει σε πόλεις και χωριά.
μιαν ανηφοριά θα πάρω μόνο πάτια να βρω τα σκαλοπάτια που πάνε στη λευτεριά. Τα σκαλοπάτια θα ανεβώ, θα μπω σε ένα παλάτι, το ξέρω θα'ν απάτη, δεν θα'ν αληθινό. Το ξέρω θα'ν απάτη, δεν θα'ν αληθινό. Μες στο παλάτι θα γυρνώ ώσπου να βρω το θρόνο, βασίλισσα μια μόνο να κάθεται σ' αυτό. Κόρη πανόρια θα της πω, άνοιξε τα φτερά σου και πάρε με κοντά σου, μονάχα αυτό ζητώ. Και πάρε με κοντά σου, μονάχα αυτό ζητώ.
Γεια σας παλιοί συμμαθητέ, τα τελευταία λόγια τα γράφω σήμερα για σας. Κι όποιος θελήσει για να βρει έναν χαμένον αδελφό, έναν παλιό του φίλο,
ας πάρει μιαν ανηφοριά, ας πάρει μόνο πάτια, να βρει τα σκαλοπάτια που πάνε στη λευτεριά. Με την ελευθεριά μαζί μπορεί να βρει και εμένα. Αν ζω θα με βρει εκεί. Αν ζω θα με βρει εκεί.
Cyprus, Greece and Hellenic diaspora expressed their sorrow for Nikos Mouyiaris' passing. In a written statement, the President of the Republic of Cyprus, Nikos Anastasiadis, said that Nikos Mouyiaris' passing was a great loss as the diaspora lost a great supporter. Nikos Mouyiaris was one of the most prominent representatives of the expatriate Cypriot Hellenism, the President of the Republic of Cyprus said. The Cypriot Foreign Minister Nikos Christodoulidis and the Cypriot government spokesman Prodromos Prodromou also expressed their regrets at Nikos Mouyiaris' passing. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Greece published a written announcement stressing that Nikos Mouyiaris was a patriot and philanthropist who contributed greatly to inspiring and mobilizing the Greek-American community, improving Greece-US relations and the causes of Hellenism. The same statement said that Nikos Mouyiaris left behind a unique legacy for Greek Americans to follow, someone who achieved the American dream while keeping Hellenism at the forefront of his heart and soul. The Hellenic American Leadership Council was one of his great gifts to Hellenism, the same statement concluded. Nikos Mouyiaris left behind his family, friends, and people who struggled for common causes.
σε μη στην πόρτα σου, για σε μη μου. Το για σε μη στην πόρτα σου, για σε μη. Κλαδέψω, ω καλή μου, και νόμισεν η μάνα σου για σε μη μου, και νόμισεν η κλέψω, ω ψυχή μου. Το για σε μη στο σου, για σε μη μου. Το για σε μη στην πόρτα σου, για σε μη
listening to Cosmos FM through WNYE 91.5 FM. This is Despina Afentouli for Cosmos FM, and tonight this program is dedicated to the memory of the businessman and philanthropist Nikos Mouyiaris. The Consul General of the Republic of Cyprus in New York, Alexis Fedonos-Vadet, spoke about Nikos Mouyiaris and his contribution to Hellenism.
Nicolas Mouyiaris was one of the first people that I met when I arrived here in New York City on June the 1st. He impressed me with his kindness and his modesty. He seemed to me to be a very humble man, despite being a great personality. And I gradually got to know him, and he was a very sweet man. However, as on January the 5th, the Greek-American community woke up to the sad news that Nikos Mouyiaris is no longer with us. Such a great personality of the Cypriot-American community, a businessman and philanthropist. And on behalf of us, I would like to express my condolences to his family. I know that he was the founder of HALC, the Hellenic American Leadership Council, and he was also a founder and benefactor of the Pan-Cyprian Theatrical Division, and many other things were created and supported by him. And as a Cypriot, I'm proud to have met him, and again express my condolences to his friends and family.
The president of PSEKA, the International Coordinating Committee Justice for Cyprus, Philip Christopher, spoke about his friendship with Nikos Mouyiaris and their common struggle about Cyprus.
First of all, let me begin by expressing my gratitude to Cosmos FM for having this program to cover and describe the contributions of a very unique individual, a remarkable man who has been my friend, my brother, for the past 45 years that we have been working together, not only on the Cyprus issue, on all the national Greek issues, and Hellenism in general. To know Nikos is almost impossible because he did not seek any recognition and he did not seek any tributes. He was an individual that worked behind the scenes, helping people. And his main objective in life was to be successful so he can generously help the Hellenic issues. So in regards to the Cyprus issue, Nikos was our main contributor to all the fundraisers for political congressmen, senators, any person that we needed to lobby. Nikos was the person that was leading that particular end of the business. In Cyprus itself, he helped many institutions, and in particular his own village where he was born in Athienou. He single-handedly revamped the village of Athienou from a museum to an orphanage to the schools. He helped every institution there was. In regards to, in general, in the United States, there's not a single organization that has not received financial support from Nikos. The Greek Studies program of Elitis at Rutgers University was rebuilt because of Nikos. The Greek Studies program of St. John's University was rebuilt because of Nikos. He was a contributor to the Hellenic Initiative. He was a contributor to every institution that helped Cyprus, and he did it in a generous way. And more than that, he was a humanitarian, a person that supported an orphanage and a school in Africa. There isn't a book that was published about Cyprus and about Greece that was not somehow supported by Nikos. Movies and films regarding Cyprus and the Cyprus tragedy were supported by Nikos. And historical situations, the film on Gazantzakis and many other films that supported Hellenism. I would think his main contribution was the founding of the Hellenic American Leadership Council, HALC, which is an organization that we should be proud of, an organization that aspires to emulate what the American Jewish Committee does, bringing together young Greek Americans of all of the United States together to promote and project Hellenism in general. So it's a sad day because at the age of 73, he had so much more to give and so much more to contribute. You know, that's life. The cancerous brain tumor took his life. He fought with courage. He fought with grace. He fought with dignity, but he could not survive this particular cancerous brain tumor. You know, the Greek Cypriot community mourns. The Hellenic community mourns the passing of a remarkable individual.
On your message on the occasion of 2015 Fidipides Award, you said that many people are successful, but few for the right reason. Please tell us more about it.
We have millionaires and billionaires in the United States that are Greek Americans. And they all contribute, but many of them contribute for recognition. Many of them contribute, and they don't contribute enough. his take in life was that you only have one life to live, and that's why Elides was his favorite poet. He told me that the only thing he needed after his death was $20. So he was basically determined to give away his wealth in promoting Hellenism and promoting Greek-American issues. From the Pan-Cyprian Association, which he was our main benefactor, to every event of Hellenic event, Nikos was on the forefront contributing money. So it's when I say that very few are for the right reason, it's because Nikos was an example of a humanitarian, a philanthropist, an individual who wanted to be successful in business so he can give money to help our causes. And I wish we had more like him.
Philip, this is for you from Nico at the Philippides Award Gala 2015.
Thank you, Demosthenes. Oh, I'm sorry. Thank you, Philip. Philip, my best friend and the greatest of the Hellenes I know, who worked for our causes for basically his whole life, who spent millions of dollars to see justice for Cyprus and a better Greek nation for us and a better Greek American community, we thank you. And we thank Chrysoula, his wife, who also for 4 years stood next to him. Thank you, Philip. A big round of applause for Philip.
Ο άνθρωπος πρέπει την πατρίδα να αγαπά. Λένε πως ο άνθρωπος πρέπει την πατρίδα να αγαπά. Έτσι λέει κι ο πατέρας μου συχνά. Έτσι λέει κι ο πατέρας μου συχνά. Η δική μου η πατρίδα έχει μοιραστεί στα δυο. Η δική μου η πατρίδα έχει μοιραστεί στα δυο. Από τα δυο κομμάτια πρέπει να αγαπώ. Ποιο από τα δυο κομμάτια πρέπει να αγαπώ.
You're listening to Cosmos FM through WNYE 91.5 FM. This is Despina Afentouli for Cosmos FM. And tonight, this program is dedicated to the memory of the businessman and philanthropist Nikos Mouyiaris. The president of the Cyprus-US Chamber of Commerce, Nicolas Nicolaou, talked about Nikos Mouyiaris as a businessman, Hellene, and philanthropist.
Nikos Mouyiaris was one of the founding members of the Cyprus Chamber and also served as a board member for many years. He was our honoree 2 years ago at our annual gala. I had the privilege to work with Nikos for 4 years at Mana Products. Nikos's passing leaves a huge gap in the community, not only for his generosity, but also for his spirit. Nikos will be remembered for many things, but I believe there are three things that set him apart from everybody else. First, as an entrepreneur. In 1975, he founded Mana Products using a $6,000 loan from his brother. Today, Mana is one of the leading contract manufacturing companies in the world in color cosmetics. He started from nothing. The second is as a Hellene. Nikos did not believe in political parties. His only party was Hellenism, Greece, and Cyprus. His passion about defending Hellenic causes was unparalleled. As a result of his passion, he founded HALC, which is today the leading advocacy organization about Hellenic issues here in the United States. And the third one is as a philanthropist. Nikos believed in helping others. Nikos has supported many Hellenic groups, organizations, charities in Africa and back in Cyprus. He supported many initiatives in his village of Athieno. He leaves behind a big legacy. Nikos has served as a role model for all of us as to how to get involved in the community and help without asking for any special recognition. He did everything behind the scenes, quietly, and he was a very humble man. Nikos was the American dream coming to life. Let's all use his passing as a call to action, to get more involved in the community, to support our community organizations, support HALC, which is the organization that Nikos founded, and help others. We have very big shoes to fill. Eonia Duimnimi.
Assemblywoman Nicole Malliotakis said that Nikos Mouyiaris was the epitome of the American dream and one of the best advocates, not only of the Greek community, but also of the Greek-American relations.
The loss of Nikos Mouyiaris is very difficult for the entire community. He is somebody that I've known for maybe 2 decades, and he is somebody who was so revered and respected and loved in the Greek community that his loss, him not being here, is going to be felt by all of us. Nikos is somebody who was a very wonderful a businessman. He was a great philanthropist. He was extremely generous to so many different organizations and nonprofits and groups. He was very supportive of the Young Hellenic Professionals Group, which is the Hellenic Professionals Group was one that advanced the agenda of the young Greek Americans and those within the business community here and in Washington. He also was very involved in our cultural institutions. But as a businessman, he was really the epitome of the American dream. When you think that he came to the United States as an immigrant, he took a loan to start his business, and he became one of the major manufacturers and distributors for cosmetics. And I will always remember Nikos as somebody who did so much for the Greek community, was always there to help. Nikos is somebody who was very supportive of me when I first announced that I was running for the State Assembly, and he supported all Greek Americans who were looking to be representatives and serve in our democracy, regardless of what their party was. But he was also very involved in Greece, United States, and Cyprus, United States relationships, and particularly when it comes to the Cyprus issue and justice for Cyprus. He was a driving force for many years, being a part of that conversation and pushing the agenda. And so, you know, we've lost an advocate. And in addition to a wonderful businessman who was the epitome of the American dream and also a great philanthropist, we lost one of the largest and the best advocates for the Cyprus issue. And, you know, we will... take the banner where he left it off and continue to fight for justice for Cyprus on Nikos' behalf. And my condolences to him and his family and the entire Greek and the Cypriot community. This is just a great loss for all of us. We're very shocked, and we're also very saddened that he will no longer be with us.
Αργώνει το κρύο και εγώ φεύγω λαλώντας το στερνό μου αντίο και τη μάνα φιλώντας την κοιτάζω να κλαίει μάνα μην κλαις και κλαίω κι όλο πάω και τρέχω και το δάκρυ της μήνει για μια μόνο στιγμούλα και μια άλλη μανούλα
Κόσμος FM, ζωντανά από τα στούντιο Καλοειδή στην Αστόρια.
You're listening to Cosmos FM on the air at 91.5 and streaming live on www.cosmosfm.org. We'd like to remind you that the opinions expressed on this program do not necessarily reflect those of the Cosmos FM staff, producers, volunteers, or the Gaiapis Board of Directors.
Και τώρα τα νέα από την Ελλάδα, την Αμερική και όλο τον κόσμο. Τα προγράμματα του Cosmos FM σας τα προσφέρουν μέλη του οργανισμού μας, καθώς και οι εταιρείες.
Homeric Tours προσφέρει ταξίδια και διακοπές στην Ελλάδα, Κύπρο, Ανατολική Μεσόγειο και Κεντρική Ευρώπη. Με γραφεία στο Manhattan, Astoria, Hicksville, Long Island, Stamford, Connecticut και στην Αθήνα. Homeric Tours 1-800-223-5570.
Terrace on the Park, ο χώρος για τις κοινωνικές σας εκδηλώσεις με θέα όλη τη Νέα Υόρκη. Το Terrace on the Park προσφέρει υψηλής ποιότητας υπηρεσίες προσαρμοσμένες στις δικές σας επιθυμίες. Εμπειρία, υπηρεσίες και εγγύηση για οποιαδήποτε δεξίωσή σας. Terrace on the Park, στο Flushing. Τηλέφωνο 718 592 5.000.
Χαίρετε κυρίες και κύριοι, στο μικρόφωνο για τις ειδήσεις ο Άγης Γιφτόπουλος. Έλληνο-γερμανικές σχέσεις, ευρωπαϊκό μέλλον, συμφωνία των Πρεσπών, μεταναστευτικό και οικονομία βρέθηκαν στο επίκεντρο της απόψινής συνάντησης του Πρωθυπουργού με τη Γερμανίδα Καγκελάριο στο πλαίσιο της διήμερης επίσκεψής της στην Αθήνα. Η Συμφωνία των Πρεσπών είναι προς όφελος της Βόρειας Μακεδονίας, της Ελλάδας και της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης, υπογράμμισε η Άγγελα Μέρκελ και απέκλεισε κατηγορηματικά τα περί συμφωνίας κάτω από το τραπέζι για ανταλλαγή του ονοματολογικού με τις συντάξεις που έχει εκφραστεί από τη Νέα Δημοκρατία. Υπάρχουν κάποιοι κανόνες, επισήμανε η κυρία Μέρκελ για τη στάση της Νέας Δημοκρατίας για το θέμα, λέγοντας ότι οι αντιπολιτεύσεις οφείλουν να ασκούν κριτική στην κυβέρνηση, αλλά θα πρέπει να υπάρχει σωστή στάση στα μεγάλα εθνικά ζητήματα. Και σημείωσε πως δεν νομίζει ότι θα μπορέσει να επηρεάσει τα πράγματα. Όσον αφορά την πορεία της οικονομίας, αφού αναγνώρισε ότι ο ελληνικός λαός πέρασε μια δύσκολη περίοδο, τόνισε ότι η χώρα μας ξεπέρασε τα προβλήματα και οι μεγάλες γερμανικές επενδύσεις στην Ελλάδα δείχνουν εμπιστοσύνη. Προσθέτοντας επίσης πως ο νέος κύκλος που ανοίγει δεν σημαίνει το τέλος των μεταρρυθμίσεων, αλλά την απαρχή μιας νέας κατάστασης. Από την πλευρά του, για εξαιρετικά επικοδομητική συνάντηση μίλησε ο Αλέξης Τσίπρας και επισήμανε τη σημασία που έχει για τα Βαλκάνια και την Ευρώπη η Συμφωνία των Πρεσπών, χαρακτηρίζοντας την σημαντικό βήμα για την ειρήνη, τη σταθερότητα και την ανάπτυξη. Για την οικονομία, ο Πρωθυπουργός υπογράμμισε πως η Ελλάδα από μέρος του προβλήματος είναι μέρος της λύσης και πρόσθεσε ότι σήμερα εξερχόμαστε από την κρίση οριστικά και πουλώνουμε σταδιακά τις πληγές, κρατώντας την κοινωνία όρθια και προστατεύοντας τους πιο ευάλωτους. Παράλληλα, αναφέρθηκε και στις ιστορικές εκκρεμότητες μεταξύ των δύο χωρών σε ό,τι αφορά τις γερμανικές επανορθώσεις και το κατοχικό δάνειο. Οι δύο ηγέτες συζήτησαν επίσης όλο το φάσμα των διμερών σχέσεων, λέγοντας ότι κλείνει ένας δύσκολος κύκλος και αρχίζει μια πιο αισιόδοξη προοπτική, ενώ συμφώνησαν η Γερμανία να είναι η τιμόμενη χώρα στη Διεθνή Έκθεση Θεσσαλονίκης το 2020. Μίλησαν ακόμη για την πορεία της Ευρωπαϊκής Ένωσης εν ώψη και των ευρωεκλογών, όπου τάχθηκαν κατά των φωνών του ακροδεξιού εθνικισμού που αποτελούν, όπως τόνισαν, το μεγαλύτερο κίνδυνο στην Ευρώπη. Ενώ για το προσφυγικό, συμφώνησαν στην ανάγκη να υπάρξει κοινή ευρωπαϊκή πολιτική με βάση τις αρχές του ανθρωπισμού και της αλληλεγγύης. Υπενθυμίζεται ότι οι μέτρα ασφαλείας στην Αθήνα είναι δρακόντια, παγορεύονται οι διαδηλώσεις σε μεγάλο μέρος της πρωτεύουσας και εφαρμόζονται έκτακτες κυκλοφοριακές ρυθμίσεις. Αύριο το πρωί, ο σταθμός του μετρό στο Σύνταγμα θα είναι κλειστός από τις 8.30 μέχρι τις 11.30, ενώ τροποποιήσεις θα γίνουν στα δρομολόγια του προαστιακού στο τμήμα Δοκίσης Πλακεντίας Αεροδρόμιο. Σύμφωνα με πληροφορίες, σήμερα ο κ. Καμένος ευχαρίστησε τους επιτελάρχες του Υπουργείου Άμυνας για τη συνεργασία τους, ενώ ο βουλευτής των ΑΝΕΛ Κώστας Κατσίκης δήλωσε στο πρώτο πρόγραμμα: «Αποσύρουμε την εμπιστοσύνη μας στην κυβέρνηση, η συνεργασία έφτασε στο τέλος της». Με το μεταξύ, αύριο θα πραγματοποιηθεί η προγραμματισμένη για σήμερα συνεδρίαση της Ολομέλειας της Βουλής των Σκοπίων σχετικά με τη συνταγματική αναθεώρηση, με στόχο να εξασφαλίσει ο Ζόραν Ζάεφ τους 80 βουλευτές.
Ακολουθούν ομογενειακές ανακοινώσεις.
Οι θυγατέρες της Ηπείρου και ο Πύρος σας προσκαλούν στη γιορτή για το κόψιμο της Βασιλόπιτας το Σάββατο 19 Ιανουαρίου στις 7 το απόγευμα στο Πολιτιστικό Κέντρο Πέτρου Πατρίδη της Εκκλησίας του Αγίου Δημητρίου στην Αστόρια. Για πληροφορίες και κρατήσεις 646-280-9956 και 917-238-4330.
Κόσμος FM, το ελληνικό κοινοφελές ραδιόφωνο.
Welcome back. You're listening to Cosmos FM through WNYE 91.5 FM. This is Despina Afentouli for Cosmos FM. And tonight, this program is dedicated to the memory of the businessman and philanthropist, Nikos Mouyiaris. The professor of biomedical engineering and director of the Laboratory of Vision Research at Rutgers University, Thomas Papathomas, spoke about Nikos Mouyiaris' contribution to Hellenism.
So in my long experience of 50 years in the U.S., Nikos Mouyiaris stands as the most generous and most inspired leader because he spoke mostly through actions rather than through words, although he had very wise words regarding what is the future of the homogenia, what's the future of the Hellenism in the U.S. In fact, I wasn't able to listen to his 20-minute or so talk that Cosmos FM put on Sunday, but my wife heard it and she said, I'd like to get the transcript of this because every young person should listen to this and every leader in the homogenia should listen to this because it's so inspired and it charts a course for the homogenia that I think is the one that's most viable.
Nikos Mouyiaris contributed to support the elitist chair of Rutgers Modern Greek Studies program. Can you elaborate on this?
As you may know, Nikos held a degree, a master's degree from Rutgers from 1971 in chemistry. And he was so moved by the fact that they gave him a scholarship, an assistantship, that, as he put it himself, didn't force me to work in restaurants, but I was able to work in an academic setting. So he was extremely grateful for this opportunity that Rutgers gave him. So about 5 years ago, Savas Konstantinidis brought me in touch with Nikos, whom I had not known personally at the time. I knew about his work, but I did not know him personally. And he pledged $600,000 to Rutgers. And again, thankfully, my wife persuaded him, it was not difficult, that it would be important to engage the community around Rutgers. And rather than give $600,000 as a gesture, to engage the community and challenge the community by giving it in three installments of $200,000 each over 3 years, and then challenging the community to raise $100,000 every year so he would match it 2-to-1. And that gave us, basically this resurrected the dreams of the Hellenic modern Greek studies at Rutgers. The plans were now much more ambitious, and he inspired optimism around him. Everywhere that Nikos went inspired optimism. And indeed, for 3 years, we raised roughly $300,000. So together with his $600,000, we reached almost $1 million, which, of course, a year later, he surpassed, because he gave another $200,000 because he was extremely motivated and inspired by a talk, by a lecture that Professor Pourgouris from the University of Nicosia gave at the Cypriot consulate. So he gave a lecture on elitism and his relationship to Cyprus, and he was so enthused by, number one, the lecture itself, which brought elitis alive in your eyes. That's how great Marinos Pourgouris was in his lecture. And also by the fact that there were so many people in the audience, standing room only, each of whom were enthusiastic about this event. And so he pledged another $200,000 for a total of $800,000 of donations, which is, as you can imagine, extremely generous.
Would you like to read some of the messages you received for the passing of Nikos Mouyiaris?
I have a message from Yannis Simonidis, who is the founder and the director of the Elliniko Theatro. So he said, we lost Nikos, and we lost a beacon of humaneness. Pharo Anthropias, he calls him Pharo Anthropias. And I'm just taking a few phrases from here and there. Dr. Panos Georgopoulos, Georgopoulos from Rutgers University, and I'm quoting, your dreams, Nikos, are now our dreams. We promise to keep them alive for you, for us, and for the generations that come after us. Now, it was moving that I received a message from Christina Zikos, who is an alumna of Rutgers University. She also took a minor in the Modern Greek Studies program. And she wrote me a message, but among other things, she mentioned, I was deeply saddened to see about the passing of Mr. Nikos Mouyiaris. He was so young and generous. It's all very tragic. And then she added that if we have an event at Rutgers in his memory, which we will, sooner than later we'll have an event to honor his memory, she said, please let me know how I can help. So here is a young student. She just graduated 2 years ago, and she feels compelled to write me a message and volunteer to help for an event to honor his memory. And that's exactly what Nikos Mouyiaris was all about. Nikos Mouyiaris was about vision and about engaging the young people, the next generation. So that's what I wanted to mention. And then Savas Konstantinidis, who brought me in touch with Nikos, and I cannot tell you how fortunate I feel that Nikos's path and my path in life crossed, because I have been inspired by Nikos more than any other person who deals with Greek American events and not events, Greek American issues in the U.S. So Sava said, "We lost our true leader who inspired us with his compassion and his vision for the new generation." So these are some of the messages that I received out of the blue. People felt compelled to write and share our sorrow and share our mourning for Nikos, but at the same time, as many of the messages convey the message that he inspired us to continue his dreams, and that's how we feel that somehow this softens our pain and our sorrow, the fact that he left dreams behind him that we can be part of.
Ήρθες στο όνειρο μου νύχτα και μου φέρνες μηνύματα. Εψιθύρισες μου κάτι κι είμαστε σε έναν παλάτι δίπλα από τα κύματα. Εψιθύρισες μου κάτι κι είμαστε σε έναν παλάτι δίπλα από τα κύματα. Στη νύχτα μέρα έφτιαξες τον πόνο μας. Είμαστε στην τζερίνια, στο λιμάνι και στο κύμα, στον παλιόν τον τόπο μας. Είμαστε στην τζερίνια, στο λιμάνι και στο κύμα, στον παλιόν τον τόπο μας. Είδαμε τις γειτονιές μας που επέζαμε μίτσι. Αγρονίζα μας η τύχη που έτρεχε και που τη βρύση το νερό γρυό γλυκί. Αγρονίζα μας η τύχη που έτρεχε και που τη βρύση το νερό γρυό γλυκί.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've been listening to Despina Afentouli and Cosmos FM special program dedicated to the memory of Nikos Mouyiaris. As aforementioned, Nikos Mouyiaris was considered as a man of inspiration and recognized for his ethos, philanthropy, altruism, and modesty. The ancient Greek statesman Pericles said, "What you leave behind is not what is engraved in stone monuments, but what is woven into the lives of others."
Ένα το χελιδόνι και η άνοιξη ακριβή. Για να γυρίσει ο ήλιος θέλει δουλειά πολύ. Θέλει νεκροί χιλιάδες να είναι στους τροχούς. Θέλει και οι ζωντανοί μας να δίνουν το αίμα τους.
Ένα το χελιδόνι και η άνοιξη ακριβή. Για να γυρίσει ο ήλιος θέλει δουλειά πολύ.
Ένα το χελιδόνι κι άνοιξε ακριβή. Για να γυρίσει ο ήλιος θέλει δουλειά πολύ.
Θέλει νεκρή
το αίμα τους. Θεέ μου πρώτο μας τώρα με χτίσες μέσα στα βουνά. Θεέ μου πρώτο μας τώρα με κλείσες μες στη θάλασσα. Σώμα του Μαγιού όπουνε πάψεις ένα μνήμα του πελαγού. Πρώτο μας τώρα μέσα στις πασκαλιές κι εσύ. Θεέ μου πρώτο μας τώρα μύρισε στην Ανάσταση.
Κόσμος FM, η πιο ισχυρή εγκεφαλική τροφή. Το σημερινό πρόγραμμα ήταν μια προσφορά των εταιριών
Antenna Sat, το ελληνικό κανάλι στην Αμερική. Όλες οι τελευταίες ειδήσεις από την Ελλάδα και τον κόσμο. Ψυχαγωγικές εκπομπές, ελληνικές σειρές και το ελληνικό ποδόσφαιρο. Ο Antenna Sat είναι διαθέσιμος από το Greek Elite Pack της Dish με πολλά ελληνικά κανάλια σε ολόκληρη την Αμερική από την Dish.
Στην Investors Bank, στόχος μας είναι να βλέπουμε τις επιχειρήσεις σας να προοδεύουν. Είτε χρειάζεστε δάνειο για να ανανεώσετε τον εξοπλισμό σας, είτε credit line, είτε χρηματοδότηση για αγορά ακινήτου, η Investors Bank είναι εδώ για να σας βοηθήσει. Πληροφορίες στο 855 422 6548 ή στο διαδίκτυο www.myinvestorsbank.com. Investors Bank. Banking in your best interest. Member FDIC. Equal Housing Lender. NMLS ID number 41179. New Greek TV. Η ελληνική τηλεόραση της ομογένειας που για περισσότερο από 29 χρόνια είναι κοντά στους Ελληνοαμερικανούς της Νέας Υόρκης. Νέα ελληνική τηλεόραση. Έρχεται καθημερινά κοντά σας ανανεωμένη στην Time Warner, κανάλι 1600, RCN, κανάλι 523. Πληροφορίες για νέους συνδρομητές www.newgreektv.com και 718-726-0900. Νέα ελληνική τηλεόραση. Η φωνή των Ελλήνων της Αμερικής. Η συχνότητα του ελληνισμού στη Νέα Υόρκη. Κόσμος FM.